Sometimes the functions in Power Query don't quite match up to the power in Excel. And this is where you either need to figure out a way to do it in Power Query, or else another consideration is to bounce through Excel. So what I've got here is a whole bunch of companies. I want to get the upper quartile, lower quartile, etc. What I want to be able to do is change what I select, let Power Query do its magic, pull out the correct data, but I want to then see the lower quartile, the upper quartile, and the median, and then it must put it into the actual list in order so we can create this chart. So what do I mean by bouncing through Excel? What you see here is just the same setup, but now we actually work through the workings. So what I've done is I've created a list of data, I've set up something that I can actually pick and choose an item. And at the moment, although you don't need it to show here, when I go and I refresh, what it's doing is going and picking out what we need. But now, depending on what comes out, I want to see an upper quartile, a medium, and a lower quartile. So the way we can do that by bouncing through Excel without having to figure out how to do it in Power Query, I've set up a table here. Quite important, I've given these names exactly the same as these names. It's not critical, but just makes your life a bit easier. The table is set up. I've labeled it upper quartile, median, and lower quartile. And now, because it's in Excel, I can actually go find the function, which works really well in Excel. It's the quartile function. I'm going to point, but make sure you point so that it notices the table. And because that's the upper quartile, I'm going to type a 3. So, okay. For the medium, I could have used the medium function, but I'm going to be consistent, stay with quartile. So again, we point there, and this one's going to be a 2. And then lower quartile, same thing. And here we put a 1. So now what we've got is, as we change this, so if I change that to big, when I refresh all, that changes, and because it's Excel, this automatically goes, looks at it, and calculates these. Now we have a table that we can put into Power Query. So I'm just going to go here, data from table or range. You'll see I called it calc, so that's fine. All I'm going to do now, I've got both of these. I'm going to just go to the thing I called selection, which was the company names. I'm going to go in and append a query as new. I'm now going to say, I'm going to append selection to this thing called calcs. And because I've made the names exactly the same, it will work well. At this stage, you may need to just make sure that that happens. So I'm going to click OK. I'm just going to give it a new name. We're going to call it final. And because what I want to do is I actually want, you'll see upper quartile, median, and lower quartiles all at the bottom. I want them to fit in the right place. I'm just going to sort this and I'll sort it ascending. And then I can go and load it back into the worksheet. So I'm just going to load it to a new worksheet, but I'll just move it straight back here. So we've got that. I'm just going to take that, Control X, just so you can see what is happening. Now we've done that. Just notice it did bring through those calcs. I don't really need them. I'm just going to right click and delete. And it automatically changes to connection only. So what you'll see now is what this is doing is you choose an area. When I click refresh, so first notice that that changes, then that changes. So we are one refresh short. So when you bounce through Excel, you need to realize that you have to do another refresh. So it's chosen the numbers, Excel has updated that, but it didn't get a chance to do this. So in order, so you'll see this lower quartile, medium, upper quartile are all down here. When I refresh again, they now get placed here. So we highly recommend, if you're going to use this, you must build in some checks. And the whole point of the checks is just to see whatever the answer is here, is it actually over here? So I would do, in this case, I'm just doing a simple VLOOKUP. I'm going to say look for the word upper quartile in this table, bring back column number 2, and the range lookup will be false. We can just copy those down, just fix the border. And then what we can do is actually build something that says, if that number over there equals that number over there, then we're just going to say okay. Otherwise, refresh again. I'm just going to paste this as formulas to avoid that border issue. So what you've now got is I can choose what I want to see, let Power Query do what it can do well. So data, refresh all. So it's gone, pulled out only the big ones. Excel then does the quartile medians, but you can see it's warning you, because you've only refreshed it once, this here is actually going to have the new data, but the old quartile and median. So it warns you, refresh again. And you'll see now it's correct. So you've got your company names, then, for example, lower quartile, median, upper quartile. So you can use this technique to bounce through Excel where it's a bit difficult or it's a bit time consuming to try and find how to do it purely in Power Query.